Thank you, Madam Speaker. Always an honor and privilege to speak in this body. And there's just been so much information about the American Jobs Act that the president has touted, that he demanded that we pass here in this room. And at the time, he had no American Jobs Act. Next day, Friday, he spent millions of dollars, taxpayer dollars, running around the country demanding that people pass his bill. And Saturday, same thing, all weekend, running around telling people to pass his American Jobs Act when there was no such bill. Monday afternoon, very late, there became a bill. It's hard to believe that this is what came out of the White House, because it does not represent what the president said he wanted to do, said he believed in. And, you know, I'm sure he doesn't have time to go through and actually read and see that the things he's saying in his speech are completely opposite of what he's doing in his so-called American Jobs Act. But that's why, after 6 days of being beat up verbally by the president for not passing his American Jobs Act, and finding that there was no such American Jobs Act on file here in the House, I needed to help the president by creating an American Jobs Act that really will create jobs. So I filed a two-page American Jobs Act that would do more than anything the president's talked about or put in writing to create jobs in America. But just since the president is obviously not aware of what's actually in his bill based on what he's saying, just in the limited time we have here, I wanted to touch on some of these things. For example, the president said over and over and over that he wants to go after these greedy big oil companies like British Petroleum, Exxon, Shell, those big companies, and that his American Jobs Act, his bill, actually will do that. It'll go after their profits. He's probably has no clue that the fact is the 3 pages of deductions that are eliminated for oil companies, they're basically for oil companies that produce less than 1,000 barrels of oil a day. They don't even apply to the people that the president says he's going after for these unseemly profits they're making. And I'm sure he's also not aware, but the fact is that over 94% of all oil and gas wells drilled on the continental U.S. are done by independent oil producers who these 3 pages will devastate and put most out of business. And so the president, by these 3 pages that I'm sure he doesn't really understand what they do, but the fact is they'll put the independent oil producers out of business. They will affect the major oil companies, because once over 94% of all oil and gas wells in America and the continental U.S. are stopped, then the major oil companies that he's demonized will actually make more money than they've ever in their history. And it will be the middle, hardworking Americans that will pay the biggest price. They're the least able to afford dramatically higher gasoline prices, but that's what will happen. Now, we're also told that we're going to go after the millionaires and billionaires that have all this money and not paying their fair share. Now, to me, if we're going to make sure everybody pays the fair share, and you got somebody like Warren Buffett that pays 15% capital gains tax, why don't we make everybody's tax 15%? Everybody in America ought to have some financial interest in seeing this government as accountable. That's what should happen. But instead, at page 134 and 35 of his bill, and again, it has to be filed in the House because it's a revenue-raising bill, and under the Constitution, they'll have to start. It's not on file. There hadn't been one Democrat willing to file this disaster of a bill that the president's out there beating us up over. And actually, he's just saying pass the American Jobs Act, which is my two-page bill that really will create jobs. But people need to know, Mr. Speaker, Madam Speaker, that the definition in here, apparently, of a millionaire and billionaire is anybody who's married and makes over $125,000 a year. For some of us, $125,000 a year is not a millionaire, billionaire, gazillionaire. This is somebody who is paying taxes. They're paying their fair share. Around, you know, they're paying over 30% of their income in taxes. Well, why shouldn't we just say, all right, ultra-rich like Warren Buffett, quit fighting not to pay the billions of dollars you owe in taxes. Just write the check.
The gentleman's time has expired.
Thank you. And I think if people will go read the president's bill, they will find out we need to pass the American Jobs Act that's on file with the House. That's my bill.